It's Tony. I am sitting in the parking lot and we just finished up doing some auditions. Yep, we got some auditions in today. Went over some of the resumes and the bios that was submitted in, watched some of the reels, and there's some good talent out there, that's for sure. But the thing that the network seemed to discuss with me a lot is my wanting to pull in actors that I just happen to love, worked with, that I like to take forward with me. So this message is specifically for those guys because I really want you to put your best foot forward. Behind the scenes, I've been sending you your audition scripts and notes so you can get them into me so that we can work together again. Well, it is very, very important to me that you follow it exactly to the details that is necessary and much needed. Details like what's requested to be in that portfolio. And in that portfolio, we're talking about having your photos. I'm sorry, the sun is really bright up in my eyes, so I can't see, and it's kind of like, I don't know, I don't even know what time it is, to be honest with you. It's just one of those days that's been kind of long, trying to get some things done, and so I just wanted to put a quick word out to you and say, pay attention, guys. Pay attention to the details. I don't want your auditions rejected because you're not paying attention to the details. Take some time out and really do your homework and do the research necessary and needed to bring forth a good audition. Some examples that was brought to my attention, and excuse me, and that is study other actors that have succeeded. Okay? You got Denzel Washington, who's done some really great work. When you study an actor, study their craft and their performance, their facial expression, the tones of their voice, how they carry themselves within the character itself, how they allow themselves to dissolve and let the character evolve to the point that you forget it's Denzel Washington. You forget that's Viola Davis until you've watched that scene of that character in action to the point that you're so in love with the character, you can't help but remember the actor. That is the secret, I believe it is. Work that character and that performance to the point that we forget you, that we want to remember you. That's what I got to say about it. Some of the other things, you know, go back. You got some great current performers, Denzel, Viola Davis, Kerry Washington, you know, I can go on with some names, you know, I can't think of names right now because I got so many things in my head, but you also have some people that have brought forth their talent for these that you are so excited about today's craft. And that's like Sidney Poitier. Oh my God. Go back and research the talent he presented in To Serve with Love or They Call Me Mr. Tibbs, you know, The Heat of the Night, I think it was called, if I remember. The facial expressions are just so magnificent that if you muted your TV, you couldn't help but be able to be like, oh man, that was an awesome, awesome thing. Oh my God, Leslie Uggams, man, she was like in Roots and did a few other projects. She was fantastic. I'm just trying to come up with other names, talented from back then. Of course, many of you are familiar with Cicely Tyson, because Cicely Tyson, woo, I just stepped out of my shoes and the ground is like super hot and it burnt my feet. We don't want that. But anyway, just, I don't want to go on and on about this video and things like that. I just basically want you to, as an actor, let's start there. As an actor, there's many of you that are on independent indie films, which is fine. But You're wanting to take it to the next level. Just like me as a film producer, independent director, I wanted to take it to the next level. In order for me to take it to the next level, I had to yield myself to learn what it takes and exercise my craft to get it more perfected. I'm not fully there yet. I'm not no well-known name person. And the key is study your craft. Study the people that have been here before you, as well as studying the people of today. The other thing that is important, hold on a second, I got somebody hiding. Oh, okay. Sorry about the close face thing. I had to check on something real quick before I kept it going. But anyway, excuse me. I'm just really trying to get to the realness of what I'm trying to bring forth to the actors that are really wanting to go to the next level. I am not trying to claim I know it all. I'm only sharing with you what I'm experiencing through actors that I've worked with, but also through film producers and directors that are teaching me and talking to me, and that I've seen hands-on behind the scenes of things actors have done, have said. And here's the thing. You hurt you more than you hurt anything. Yeah, you might touch the project a little bit and cause situations. You know, some projects actually gets canned because of foolishness of actors and trying to carry forth their ego instead of their artwork, getting personal and trying to discredit instead of support and encourage. Because here's the thing. We are all really in this together. And we got to find a way to work as a team. Don't look for ways to tear down. Look for ways to empower and build up. That is the key to success. What are you giving back? And giving back is not always a monetary thing. Sometimes giving back is your talent. Sometimes giving back is your character, how you are as a person, your ethics, your support, your encouragement, your sharing of the craft, other people's craft, your fellow actors, your peers. You know, here's the thing, and I'd hate to say it this way, but it's the only way I know to say it. Actors, when you do things that cause a project to go to the can, you hurting you, because they're going to keep going. And you got to keep in mind, they're the writer and the creator and the producer of that project. And they're bringing you on in confidence to help you out. So anything you do, as far as the director's concerned, or even the writer or the producer, is irrelevant. You need to be focused in on what can I bring to this table, not take away from it. And if you decide to quit, you're not hurting anybody but yourself. If you decide to discredit your actor, co-peer, or your director, or the project itself, you're hurting you. So you got to get your act together and start acting like an actor and a business person and build a good, positive, solid brand. We don't black market people or blacklist people. You blacklist yourself by how you want to act. So get their act together, because so many things are coming forward in the near future that you could be a part of, but you're not a part of it and won't be a part of it as long as you got the negativity that a producer or a filmmaker don't want to be dealing with. And it's not just me, it's other film producers. You would be amazed at the things that actors are putting forth in a negative way towards film producers, and they're going way over the top to try to help you have a way to work your craft. But instead of you working your craft, you're doing all this stupid negative stuff, and you're making it harder for the next actor who has to go so many steps above just because of the steps you did. So be an example for other actors as your peers would want to follow you. Again, I didn't mean to go into all this kind of stuff, but you know, after coming out of this meeting, it was just so important to me to talk to you today to say, get it together. Rise above. You gotta rise above and get yourself together. You know, I'm out here trying to get my little hustle on because I want to see an Oscar. But an Oscar going to come to me, not only through my talent of writing and putting forth a good film, but you. So you are important as far as I'm concerned. That's the reason I talk about actors on my page as I do and put forth the lessons and the nuggets and the notes and my journey, because I want you to be able to get the real picture that is bigger, so much bigger than you and I. But it's not going to happen if you don't pull it together. So again, I'm sorry for the long message. I hope one word I've spoken will be something that triggered something in you that will make you go back to your table. I'm at my table trying to make all my corrections and fix my direction to make something happen for myself, because I'm the only one that can do that. But you are the only one that can do it for yourself. Build your brand, but build your brand on something good. So actors that are actors, actresses, even the crew, when you are invited, and that is an invitation of an invite to be part of someone's project. It's not necessarily my project, but somebody's project. I'm not speaking for anybody. I'm just saying, bring something that's empowering of yourself to that cast, to that director's project, so that it can be something good enough that people will want to see, that business executives will want to invest in and be willing to distribute. Some films may not make it past YouTube, but you got to look at the picture. Don't be so small thinking. Even if you're on YouTube, Vimeo, any of those online pages that you get out there on, guess what? That's a visual of your work. It used to be that you, no one could know anything about you, who you are, or what you're doing. Not your family, not your friends, not us, not viewers will know what you're doing if it wasn't for those sites to upload those videos of your work. So don't take it for granted because it's there and you think, oh, it's not good because it's not on Netflix, it's not on a television station, it's not on a big screen. Baby, it's you. It's your work. It's your talent. It's a way to see you. It's your reel. You may not got it directly from your director to be a reel, but go make it into a reel yourself. You could do that, but do something to make your career advance. You guys, I love you, and I want you to do well. I wouldn't put myself out here the way I have because I'm really a seclusive kind of person where I stay in. I don't really into all that stuff. But I'm putting myself out there for you so that you can have an opportunity to see the behind the scenes, the bigger picture, so that you can get some level of success. And I count success a level if you just step out on faith and just do it myself personally. But when you get a result, that is like the most awesome, magnificent glory that you can experience. Because you got to think about the time before. There was no way. There were no tools for you to be able to put your work out there. Today you have tools, social media, all kinds of downloads for your work to be seen, for you to be known. But you are neglecting it because you want the big title. You want the big title. You want the name in the big screens. You want to be an A-lister. The only way that's going to happen is if you perfect your craft to the point that you get a gig that will make that happen for you. But you're not going to get that gig if you're not willing to put forth that work and show yourself approved. How can I say that enough? You've got to show yourself approved. Don't think just because you're pretty, handsome, got a great body, muscular, good looking, all that good stuff, is all you need. Because if that was the case, you'd be up there in the limelight without us, period. No, it takes work behind all that beauty. What is your talent? Don't perfect your beauty. I'm not going to say that. Don't perfect your beauty, because beauty is lovely. We all try to look good, but you got to perfect the under level foundation of that beauty. Who are you as a person? What are your ethics, your values? What is your work ethics? And when you are doing a project with somebody, what are you bringing to that table for the craft and the talent and the artistic skills that you have? What are you bringing to the table? Are you coming with empowerment, or are you coming to deflate? See, that's what you got to look at. It's a bigger picture out here, and it's a tough, tough industry for everybody. It's not just for you that's tough. It's tough for me. It's tough for the crew. It's tough for the cameraman. It's tough for the industry that of executives to invest in you. It's tough because what happens is they're taking a chance. Ain't no guarantee that what you write, what you perform, what gets shown at the big screen or on the television station or even on the internet, there is no guarantee that it's going to be a big success. The only guarantee is how the viewer reviews it. Do they like the story? Do they like the show itself? Do they like the character? Yes, the character. The character, I'm going to say it like I wrote it. The character is the most important part of the movie or any project you do, whether it's a series, web series, TV, it doesn't matter. The character is the value to the project. We all a team behind the scenes trying to bring forth a character that comes to life for the viewer. Does the viewer connect? Can we make them feel what that character's going through? Because we all experience something through the writing story of the character. But the key of the matter is your deliverance as the performer to make me, the viewer, feel it, see it, and want to remember it. Don't perform for me to want to forget you. Perform to make me want to remember you. Again, I hope I said something that makes you feel that you grow another level to make your hustle right. Because, baby, there is room out here for you, but you got to operate with some excellence. I wanted to say elegant, but I knew that wasn't the word I was trying to say. You want to get to the point of operating in elegance. That's it, okay? God bless you. I love you. I want you to win. I want to win. But how do we empower one another in an industry such as this? That is the question. God bless you. Again, I hope you got something out of this. Make it happen.